शंकर साई शिवा,
हर हर शंकर साई शिवा,
भस्म विभूषित भवानी शंकर, भवभयनाशा भोला शंकर, शिवाय शिवाय नमः, ओम नमः शिवाय शिवाय नमः, ओम नमः शिवाय शिवाय नमः, ओम नमः शिवाय शिवाय नमः, भस्म विभूषित भवानी शंकर।
श्री कृष्ण कृष्ण घन सिंह घन श्याम श्याम मुरलीधर,
ठीक। सिंधु पाहि
स्वामी नाथ साई करुणा सिंधु पाहि
पांडुरंग प्रभु विठला
Yeah. जयकार, अम्बे रानी तेरी जय जयकार। माता रानी तेरी जय जयकार, अम्बे रानी तेरी जय जयकार। ओ माता रानी तेरी जय जयकार, अम्बे रानी तेरी जय जयकार। माता रानी तेरी जय जयकार, अम्बे रानी तेरी जय जयकार। माँ शिरावाली माँ जोतावाली, माँ शिरावाली माँ जोतावाली, पहाड़ा वाली माता गवाली। प्रेम से बोलो, सारे बोलो, सब मिल बोलो, माँ से बोलो, माता रानी जय जयकार, अम्बे रानी जय जयकार, माता रानी जय जय रानी तेरी जय जयकार, माता रानी तेरी जय जयकार, अम्बे रानी तेरी जय जयकार, माता रानी तेरी जय जयकार, माता रानी जय जयकार, अम्बे रानी जय जयकार, माता रानी जय जयकार, अम्बे रानी जय जयकार, प्रेम से बोलो, सारे बोलो, सब बोलो, माँ से बोलो, प्रेम से बोलो, सारे बोलो, सब बोलो, माता रानी जय जयकार, अम्बे रानी जय जयकार, माता रानी जय जयकार, अम्बे रानी जय जयकार, माता रानी जय जयकार, अम्बे रानी जय जयकार, ओ माता रानी जय जयकार, अम्बे रानी जय जयकार, ओ माता रानी जय जयकार, अम्बे रानी जय जयकार, माता रानी जय जयकार, अम्बे रानी जय जयकार, माता रानी जय जयकार।
रानी तेरी जय जयकार।
अंजना नंद वीरम अशोक वन संचारम का भर
ध्वज गोविंद नारायणा
शंकर देवा
असुर विनाशा
नारद सिंह असुर विनाशा
त्रैलोक पारा
त्रैलोक पारा
सिंह मुख धारी हरि नारायण
सिंह मुख धारी हरि नारायण
प्रहलाद रक्षक हरि नारायण
Hello!
नारायणं भज नारायणं
तो
thought for the day. Life is a bhajan. Sing it. That is what Krishna taught through his life. Arjuna heard Krishna's Gita on the battlefield, where tensions were at their highest, and when the fate of millions was to be decided by the sword. Krishna sang the Gita for Arjuna to listen. Gita means devotional song, and he sang because he was Ananda, divine bliss, wherever he might be, in Gokulam, on the banks of the Yamuna, or at Kurukshetra, between the warring armies. You too must pass your days in bhajan. Let your whole life be a bhajan. Believe that God is everywhere at all times, and derive strength, comfort, and joy by singing his glory in his presence. Let melody and harmony surge up from your hearts, and let all take delight in the love that you express through that bhajan. Baba.
Om Shri Sai Ram, I offer myself at the divine lotus feet of our most beloved Guru, God, and best friend, Bhagwan Shri Satya Sai Baba. And thus concludes the longest Akhanda Bhajan ever to be conducted in the holy precincts of the Sarvadharma Service Center with Bhagwan's divine grace, 29 hours nonstop, offered at his divine lotus feet. I have no words. This is in the last 29 years that I have had the opportunity to spend on this planet. These have to be the best 29 hours so far. And for that, there are so many people to whom we need to express our gratitude to. And at the outset, I request for your forgiveness if I miss anyone, but just a few that I would like to highlight. First, my parents, Mom, Dad, Hakka, and Dilip, for your constant guidance, support, and effort that you have put in to make this event happen every single year for 20 years in a row. And of course, my siblings, Prachi, Niral, Shivani, Naveen, and my nephew, Avi, and my newest nephew, Neve, without whom this family would be, without the support of my family, you know, I would not be where I am today, and without their love, support, and guidance. So thank you, and I express my gratitude. Of course, the beautiful venue that we have been blessed to, all of you have been here for 29 hours, but myself and more of the support crew have been here for almost a week. What other venue will give you the opportunity to come even 1 week in advance and do all of the setup work so that we have full confidence and faith that we are putting our best foot forward and offering our best to Swami? So give us that opportunity, the Sarvadharma Service Center. In particular, Mahesh Velanki, Uncle Mahesh Dontam Setti, Hanumantrao Andavolu Uncle, Sai Barade Uncle, and of course, our unsung hero, Ram Ragbir Uncle, who is constantly running around the building, taking care of the premises. Of course, without bhojan, bhajan is incomplete. And so many thanks to the food team who made arrangements to feed all of us over the last 29 hours. And special thanks to those who cooked and brought food from their homes. It was truly delightful and sustained us to have the best Akhanda Bhajan I have ever experienced in my whole life. So thank you. Without bhajan, this event would not exist. And for that, I have to thank the entire Rutbab Bhajan team. First and foremost, Sidhu, whose long-term planning, oversight, foresight, strategy, graphic design, and attention to detail and quality has made this an offering at Swami's lotus feet. And a special mention to Brother Sai Santosh, who could not be here today. Pranav, his name speaks for himself. He is the embodiment of sound, and without his sound and energy, this, you know, as talented as these musicians are, without proper sound and audio coordination, it would all be a wash. So many thanks to Pranav, Sidhu, and all of you who have helped us with the sound arrangements. Ashish, I like to call him my stress buster. Not only has he ran up and down the length and breadth of the state of New Jersey to pick up and drop off people and food, he opened up his home 2 weeks ago when I flew out to middle of nowhere, Kansas, just so that we could sit in person to start working on the Rutbab Bhajan list. So he has been truly an instrumental force and not only helping plan the bhajan aspect, but also the logistics of transport and accommodation. So many of you have come from such long distances, and without the wonderful logistical efforts put in by Ashish, it would have not have been as seamless as it was. So thank you for that. And with that, of course, many thanks to the families who hosted all of the young adults who have flown in from all over the country, and also the devotees who helped with airport pickups and drop-offs. Arvind, we call him, you know, the supreme commander of the armed forces, because the strength that he has in his hands is one of the vital forces that keeps the Akhanda Bhajan running for 29 hours long. So without his power and insight, this would be incomplete. And of course, his sister, Akshaya, whose name literally means infinite. When Akshaya is on the team, there is no lack. There is no lack of time. There is no lack of resources. It feels like everything just stretches. Everything expands. You know, Swami says expansion is his life. And I think Akshaya is truly an embodiment of that. So without your presence on the team, it would be impossible. Sejal and Sneha, two sisters who have gone through so much with, you know, especially selecting the special compositions and assigning them to specific singers, right? And fun fact, we had 7 hours of special compositions offered this year, which Swami has blessed, you know, people in this congregation to compose, namely Siddharth, myself, Krishna uncle, Soham, Sai Satvik, who is just a young 13-year-old, composed beautiful bhajans, Sai Ram Sondararajan, Brother Sai Santosh Srinivasan, who could not be here, Navitri, who is here with us, all of these beautiful devotees have been inspired by his love to compose these bhajans. So thanks to all of you for sharing your love, and thank you to all of you who took out the time to learn these special compositions. It truly does take a lot of time and effort, and you have rendered them with such love and devotion at Swami's lotus feet. Radhika, our slides queen, being on top of every single little change that we made throughout the planning process and even during the bhajan session. And of course, Navitri for literally doing penance for this offering to come to fruition today. Every call, every drop of sweat and tears that have been shed in preparation for Radbab 2024, she has been through it with me from the start, and congratulations on your first full in-person end-to-end Radbab planning process. Many more to come. Last night, Arvind and I sang a bhajan, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. That means Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. And one of the commandments that Prophet Muhammad gave us, peace and blessings be upon him, was that the Friday prayer that the Muslims do, that is the Jummah prayer, that prayer, every Muslim is mandated to do that prayer in a congregational setting. And Prophet Muhammad said that every additional individual that is added to this congregation increases the merit and the benefit of that prayer 27-fold. And so here we have gathered almost 200 loving devotees, uncles, aunties, brothers, sisters, and most of all family. We have all gathered today as one family at Swami's lotus feet to sing his glory for 29 hours long, for 29 hours nonstop. I am sure that we will all carry these vibrations home with us throughout the year and throughout our lives. And as we always say, it does not end here. As the human lifespan, according to the World Health Organization in the United States of America, is about 80 years, and there are 525,600 minutes in 1 year. So if you do the math, and if you count about 3.75 minutes per bhajan, in one human lifespan, we have the opportunity to sing 11.2 million Sai bhajans. We are blessed that Swami has given the opportunity to sing almost 500 Sai bhajans over the last 29 hours. And so, without this congregation that has gathered from, of course, our home state, New Jersey, New York, Texas, Kansas, Florida, Georgia, Boston, the DC capital area region, and of even Canada, this offering would not be complete without this congregation. And so many, many thanks to all of you for coming, attending, and giving your love and energy into this offering. And we submit humbly ourselves at Bhagwan's divine lotus feet. Just a few logistical announcements to conclude. We're trying something a little new with the dinner today. We understand everyone has been here for more than 29 hours, and folks who have long distance to travel, you know, they can reach home at a reasonable time. So we have lovingly prepared, the food team has lovingly prepared dinner prasadam for everyone to go in beautiful bags. So please do take that on your way out. However, if you do wish to partake of the prasadam here, you are welcome to receive your bag and go downstairs to the cafeteria and eat there as well. And we can all eat together. So it's up to you, you know, based on your timing and flexibility. There's, as you can see, there is a ton of audio, video, and decor that needs to be cleaned up, which we would like to do today. So I understand everybody wants to get to that as fast as possible, but we would like to allocate maybe just 15, 20 minutes after Arati is offered to Swami to take pictures and socialize. And then, you know, once that is done, we have a cleanup crew that has been established. All of you on the cleanup crew have been notified. Please be at your stations, and we'll start the, after, you know, the proceedings are finished, we'll start the cleanup process maybe 15 to 20 minutes right after. At that point, we will ask everyone to exit the hall except the cleaning volunteer so that we can clean up in the most efficient and quickest way possible. And am I missing anything, co-executive? All of you must be wondering now that we've, the greatest souvenir that we can take home from an Akhanda Bhajan is of course the recordings. The recordings will be made, YouTube has certain restrictions that they'll only store a video that's less than 12 hours. This video is of course more than 30 hours long at this point, so YouTube will automatically be deleting it. So we will take due diligence, and not just the audio that was heard in the broadcast, but as you see, Brother Siddharth and Pranav have set up very diligently mics all around the hall that have captured the sound, so they're going to mix and master that with the direct line input and very high studio quality recordings of the Akhanda Bhajan that will be repatched with all the videos taken, will hopefully be offered at Swami's lotus feet by the end of this coming week or probably next week. So within 1 or 2 weeks, it's going to be a very long process. So do look out for that. And anything else? Yes, very important announcement. As you all know, just about a month ago, we had the epic Chandi Sahita Atirudra Mahayagna right here in these holy precincts of Sarvadharma Service Center. And as I was mentioning to many of you before, I am sure it is because of the vibrations left behind by charm. And I'm sure many of you are here who are blessed to attend that event, felt those vibrations so strongly. We're so blessed that those vibrations have carried forward to this Akhanda Bhajan. And I think Rudbev 2024 has had a totally different feel, totally different level of spiritual energy because of the Chandi Sahita Atirudra Mahayagna. So in addition to one more additional prasadam that you can take home is the Tirtham from the Yagna. During the Yagna, there were about 150 Kalashams installed all over the Yagnashala, and in which each Kalasham, a different deity, different form of divinity was invoked. And that water has been, that those Kalashams were worshipped for those 10 days and chanted over. And that water has been collected and nicely packed in sealed bottles. So even if you're flying, you should be able to fly with them in your carry-on suitcases. So they are also kept outside with the Tugo Prasadam. Please to take one bottle. Yes. And I would like to give the mic to Hanumantra also.
Sairam, everyone. Just wanted to say that you will find some sediment within the Tirtham. So don't get offended by it, or don't get afraid of it. What it is that these are all the things that have been added to the Abhishekam waters for preservation. So these are preservatives that are in there. You can either get rid of them by filtering it, or you can take it as it is. I just wanted to say that, because otherwise people can get really very unhappy to see that.
Thank you,
sir.
And one more note from Sidhu. Feel free to upload any pictures and videos that you have taken onto your personal social media channels. Please use our hashtag, Rudbev2024, so that we can all view those memories together and keep them for posterity. And with that, I would like to invite my mom, my nephew Avi, and for the first time, my nephew Neve as well, to join me at the altar to offer Mangalarti to Swami.
Oh. जय बोलो भगवान श्री सत्य साई बाबा जी की
जय।
परमं पवित्रं बाबा विभूतिं परमं विचित्रं नीरा विभूतिं
जय बोलो